Hi, it's Handy Andy Tech Tips here, and in part one of this series, we looked at the main reason why you might want to buy an SSD, which is its speed. In this episode, we're going to look at reliability. In other words, is an SSD really more reliable than a traditional hard drive? Well, the answer depends on the particular kind of flash memory which is being used. It can either be SLC, which is common in professional applications, or MLC, which is more of a consumer grade. To explain this, I'm going to show you a MOSFET, which is essentially a type of transistor. It works a little bit like a switch, where the control gate is the switch itself, the source is the input terminal, and the drain is the output. So firstly, I'll put a little bit of current on the source, and you can see that no electrons are flowing, and most importantly, nothing is coming out of the drain. But as soon as you activate the switch, in other words, apply current to the control gate, electrons start flowing and the circuit is complete. Works pretty well, doesn't it? But the only problem is that you can't store the state that the MOSFET was in when the power was switched off. Obviously, for non-volatile SSD storage, this is not good enough, which is why we add this component, the floating gate. Now, when a very high voltage is applied to the control gate, electrons flowing through this channel have a tendency to break through the oxide layer and get trapped in the floating gate. This makes possible the storage of binary information in each cell. In order to read it, we apply a charge to both the control gate and the drain, and we measure the conductivity of the channel. Essentially, if the floating gate holds a charge, then no current will flow through the cell and the result will be a binary zero. On the other hand, if there's no charge in the floating gate, then current will flow and the result is a binary one. Now you can see how this process might be a little bit destructive to the cell over time. This is because the oxide layer, which, for lack of a technical term, stops the charge from escaping, will gradually erode. And this is the single biggest reason why MLC flash is less reliable than SLC. You see, in a single level cell system, a single bit is stored in each cell. So that means that each distinct voltage stored in the floating gate occupies 50% of the maximum range. But with a multi-level cell system, since the maximum voltage is around about the same, you can actually pack twice the amount of information in the same amount of space. But unfortunately, all this extra capacity doesn't come without a price. One major problem is that MLC flash has far tighter tolerances, because the guard band, e.g. the difference between the states, is massively reduced. But the main problem is obviously that less cells will be used to store the same amount of data, meaning that each one will wear out more quickly. So MLC flash only has around 10,000 program array cycles per block. Is this enough? Well, it's been argued that the adoption of such techniques as wear leveling and over-provisioning, which basically spread out the read-write cycles evenly amongst all the cells in the SSD, will offset such a limitation. In fact, I'd argue that in most consumer applications, MLC SSDs are just as reliable as conventional hard drives. I mean, just consider the wide array of failure points which they have. They can be affected by stray magnetic fields, they can have a head crash, or they can just be subject to simple mechanical wear and tear. And that's not just what I think either. A remarkable study undertaken by the Tech Report has shown that some consumer drives are capable of an amazing 2 petabytes of writing. And in my mind, this, if nothing else, just confirms the absolute reliability of an SSD. Anyway, I'm Handy Andy, and I really hope you enjoyed this 2-part series. If you'd like me to do more multi-part series, then please post a comment below. And as always, thank you very much for watching my video.